Welcome back, you with the morning news. Well, the internet will be a major battleground in this year's federal election, and many have wasted no time pushing their agendas. As we saw earlier this morning, the Australian Workers' Union has launched an Adams family-style attack on Tony Abbott and his Liberal Party colleagues overnight. For more, we're joined this morning by Paul Howes from the AWU. Good morning, Paul. Thanks so much for your time this morning.
Good morning, Natasha.
A lot of creativity has obviously gone behind this latest ad campaign. What's the thought process behind it and what type of message are you trying to send out?
Well, it's always good to have a bit of colour and movement and fun in an election campaign, but also it's equally important that we remind working Australians that Tony Abbott represents a real threat to their working lives. He may be saying one thing, but we know deep down Tony Abbott is a politician that believes in work choices. We know that when he wrote his book, looking back on the record of the Howard government, he thought that work choices was the proudest and greatest achievement of the Howard government. And whilst he may have yesterday said that his work choices were dead and buried, we had just last night on ABC, Julie Bishop, the deputy leader of the Liberal Party, refusing to rule out future changes to industrial relations under a Liberal Party government.
But Paul, Mr Abbott has said this morning, even in response to those comments last night, that the Liberal Party is on the same page and that work choices is dead, buried, cremated and not going to come back now or ever. What more ironclad guarantee do you want than that?
Well, we had that statement from Tony Abbott, but we still haven't heard from Erica Betts, who said that he would, as Workplace Relations Minister, and this is Tony Abbott's spokesman on Workplace Relations, he would tweak the Labor's Fair Work legislation to make changes. Now, the type of changes we know that the Liberal Party wants to make is things like removing unfair dismissal protection for 2.3 million working Australians, reintroducing things like the Australian Workplace Agreements, which rip away at our social wage, undermine the safety net, and leave working people more vulnerable and worse off. The reality is we can't trust what Tony Abbott says when he's on the run. He said that himself. He said in the past, don't always take what I say on the run as being the gospel truth. We know for decades, even before he was in Parliament, he's had an ideological drive to change workplace relations laws in this country to make them like work choices as existed under the Howard government. And I bet my last dollar he'll do the same if he wins government after August 21st.
Paul, well, moving now on to the Gillard government. Now, there's reports today an employment task force from the Gillard government supports the continued use of foreign labour to fill worsening skills shortages on major resources project. Are you fearful that Australian workers will be worse off under that proposal? And why do you believe the Gillard government will be better for Australian workers than the Abbott government?
Well, the task force you're referring to wasn't just a government task force. It was a task force that brought together unions, community leaders, education institutions, businesses. In fact, I was a member of that task force. Now, no one wants to use foreign labour in this country, and where we can deploy domestic labour and upskill our workforce, we should always do that. But equally, we shouldn't hold our economy back simply because of labour shortages. We know that we are almost unique in the world in terms of record low unemployment, hovering around 4%. If you look to the United States, they have unemployment levels upwards of 10% at the moment. As the resources boom continues and builds stronger, it's important that we as a nation harness all the potential that the resources boom represents, and sometimes that might mean using limited levels of foreign labour. But ultimately, what the task force has recommended and what the main thrust of that report was about was upskilling young Australians, ensuring those young Australians who are living in the western suburbs of Sydney or the western suburbs of Melbourne who don't have access to the jobs in resource-rich states like Queensland and Western Australia are able to be provided access to those jobs through upskilling of our young people, through proper building of trade schools and ensuring that they can then have the mobility that's required to move to areas like the Pilbara in Western Australia so they can also share in this wealth.
Paul, just quickly, the union power brokers were instrumental in toppling Kevin Rudd and replacing him with Julia Gillard. Do you think the latest opinion polls vindicate the position that Kevin Rudd was knifed by his own party?
Well, look, I certainly think that since Julia Gillard has taken the leadership of the party, that Labor has certainly got its mojo back. We've gone message, and Labor is ensuring that they are focused on the issues that matter to move Australia forward. Now, Liberal Party spin doctors will tell you that this was a ruthless knifing by union leaders. That's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. The Parliamentary Labor Party made the decision to change leaders, and the Parliamentary Labor Party was right in the decision that they made. And now the important thing is that the Australian people have a good and frank look at two very different leaders. One leader who wants to move the country forward to keep Australia strong, and one leader who wants to take Australia back to the worst aspects of the old days of the Howard government.
Paul House, thanks so much for your time this morning. The Australian public will decide.
Thanks, Natasha.